Do people still say I'm fleek? I thought I was gonna pull like a little girl with long hair out of the drain.
Magical place of goodness. Yo.
I don't wanna cry.
I feel like I'm gonna shit my pants.
So my boyfriend and I broke up, and then I developed a piercing bump that just won't seem to go away no matter what I try. I've been sick for the whole last week. And okay, sure, some of those might be minor inconveniences, but girl, then my car broke. And I'm not saying like broke down, like give her a little jump start, kiki, it's all fixed. No, she broke, like she needs to go in the dumpster fire trash. Otherwise, I have to pour thousands of dollars into her. So I'll probably have to be buying a new car, which like in this economy. So I'm not gonna lie, your girl has been on the mental health struggle train this month. I've kind of let just my life fall to shambles. It's okay, because I was just laying in bed, like low key crying because I was just struggling with everything that's gone on this month. And then I was like, oh girl, pick yourself up. You need to be on your boss girl shit. I thought it's time to glow up. Today we're taking control of our life and I'm gonna go through a whole physical and mental glow up. So here's a list of everything I want to do to glow myself up. We'll be starting with the physical, because you know, sometimes you just gotta like look pretty before you can make yourself like feel pretty and good. This video is also gonna be filled with a bunch of honestly embarrassing stuff about how I've been dealing with life in the past month, so bear with me. But the first one being, it's been a while since I've showered, I'm not gonna lie. And so I really wanna detox. I wanna get all the dead, sickly skin cells off of me. So we're gonna go to Target and we're gonna get a nice body scrub and we're gonna shower with it and we're gonna shave my legs and it's gonna be a beautiful moment. Let's go to Target. So luckily I am very, very blessed. And my grandma is letting me use her car while I figure out what I'm gonna do with my car. So luckily we can still get around. But yeah, for now, let's head to Target. Also, happy October, guys. It's October 1st, the day I'm filming this. And look, I'm wearing my little skull earrings. I literally have to. Okay, also this Target is low-key kind of scary. I almost got human trafficked here once, but it's okay because it's daylight. So I feel like we won't get trafficked in broad daylight. Bruh. Oh my gosh, girl math is telling me that if I spend 25, I'm only really spending 20 because I'm getting a $5 gift card. I love being a girl that's so mathy. Okay, here's our options. We gotta smell them all. Okay, cinnamon dolce caught my eye because I love the smell of like sweet baked goods. That is luscious. It smells very much like cinnamon, but they also have a pumpkin spice latte one. Ooh, I can hear the like little grits when I'm trying to open it. Oh my god, that's good too. Wow, that actually really smells like a pumpkin spice latte. I'm not really as much into the fruity scent, so I feel like I'm gonna skip that. Well, I'm like kidding. This is strawberry. Oh no, okay. This smells like candy. Yeah, let's keep with the sweet scents. Okay, the last option is iced coffee. No, thank you. Let's go cinnamon dolce. Okay, I really was gonna try to spend 25 to get to the coupon to get the $5 off gift card, but this is only $8, so I would have to spend another 10 plus 5 plus 2 is $17. I was like looking in the makeup section, but then I just remembered like we're trying to stay on a budget, guys, so like we're just gonna get the $8 scrub and call it a day. Budget friendly, glow up, here we come. It's shower time. I want y'all to experience the amazingness of a shower that hasn't been taken in maybe a week. Oh my god, that's so embarrassing. And also just enjoy the cinnamon dolce delight with me. And also, I thrifted this bikini top like a while back. Isn't that so cute? Like she's a little goth moment. Let's get to detoxifying ourselves. Okay. Okay, I forgot that it doesn't automatically turn on hot.
Are you dumb?
Literally just the water feels so good.
All right, now we gotta start with our shampoo, y'all. Lather that shit in. I swear I heard the bacteria screaming a little when I was washing them out. Then I put in my silky conditioner, make that shit sleek and slay. Once my hair was all gooped up, it was time to go in with the product that was really what was gonna glow me up. Rub that shit in. I was talking in this clip, but my shower head just loves to be a little and screech, so I figured I'd voice over. But I was just saying that it smells like gingerbread houses and that I normally don't treat myself to skincare or like shower products, but this is like, oh, literally amazing. You can see the grains in it. They're just little scrubbies that are really exfoliating, taking off all that dead skin, taking out that dead part of your life physically. Ugh. We just love it. Then it was leg shaving time. And oh my gosh, y'all. So much hair came up of the little razor. That's honestly so satisfying. Then I finished it off with my $3 soap.
Oh my gosh. I swear showering is like having God cry tears of joy upon your skin. It literally is like life-saving. It feels so good. And especially with that shower scrub, y'all. It was worth the $8. Now that we're showered and cleaned, we're gonna go pick up some makeup for our glowy makeup routine. I already bought a lot of new makeup products like 2 weeks ago or something, so I really don't need to buy any more, but my mascara did run out, so we are gonna make a quick Ulta trip and pick up some mascara. And this is also basically free because I got an Ulta gift card from my optometrist. Love you, Dr. Trong. Thanks, girl. And so, again, girl math, it's basically free mascara. So let's go.
We're here at Ulta. So I used to use L'Oreal Lash Paradise. Then I switched to Essence Mascara, but I don't think it was as good as Lash Paradise. So I'm gonna go back to Lash Paradise, but I'm gonna do the waterproof version this time. Oh my gosh, y'all, it's literally the last waterproof one. Oh my gosh. I feel like that means it's good, right? Oh my gosh, y'all, I'm feeling a calling. Something is calling my name. I hear my name. Allie, Allie, come get me. Come pick me up. Hair dye. Y'all, I really want to change up my hair so bad. Like, this blue could be magical or like a dark red. Okay, but realistically, my hair is so damaged from how much I've dyed up before that I need to go to a professional to figure this out. So sadly, we won't be dyeing our hair today. But don't worry, because after we do our makeup, there is something hair related we are doing to glow up. You guys, hear me out. I really wanted a strawberry shake, y'all. Shake secured. I got a strawberry shake. Okay, guys, I know. Okay, it's not necessarily like glow up healthy moment, but it's a fruit shake, so like it's basically healthy.
Okay, moment of truth, taste test. Oh my gosh, creamy deliciousness. Almost gonna bring me to tears. Yeah, that was 100% worth the $6.
What time is it, Jinxie? What time is it? It's makeup time.
Now, as I said, the only new product that I got is the mascara. Everything else is still like relatively new, like it's from like the last 2 weeks. But I will like tell what products I'm using. So if you yourself are also glowing yourself up, you can consider buying these products. So I started using sunscreen like a few months ago because I realized I wanna look young forever. Also, I don't wanna get skin cancer. Sunscreen first, I already put it on today though since we went out. Then I'm squirting this I have no idea how to say it. All over my luscious face. Look at that, like dewy queen. So I just put that over my sunscreen, give myself a little spray. Sparkle Glow. Then we got our e.l.f. Halo Glow skin tint slash foundation, but it's not really foundation. It's more of a skin tint. And I like this because it's light coverage. I like the natural glow, you know what I mean? And I'm just gonna dab that all into my beautiful luscious skin. Jinxie, girl. She is not supposed to be scratching the wall. I'm also gonna put this brow gel, or actually it's hair gel. I'm gonna rub that on my brows to prep them for brow pencil later on. Then I'm gonna do my concealer. Little glow, little lightning, little angel moment. Bye bye to my dark circles. Y'all, I don't know if I'm gonna actually use this particular picture in the thumbnail because it's low-key atrocious. But this morning, you know, before I started my little glow up, I took this selfie for the thumbnail. And the first one I took, this is like what I looked like. Like, that is freaking ghastly. I'm actually terrified. Like, why are my bags so baggy? Ugh, I'm telling you, it's been tough. Okay, now that the concealer has blended, oh, we're already looking so glowy. Now I'm gonna use this Rare Beauty blush. Mwah. This is literally the first liquid blush I've ever used in my 22 wise years of life, but I literally love it. Oh, look at how pretty that is. Look how pretty. Gorgeous, gorgeous babes. Something about me just feeling so pretty. It's time for eyeliner. I've been using this Epic Ink NYX eyeliner for years, and I would say it's a really good eyeliner and it's cheap. So, highly recommend. We're just gonna do our normal cute little wings because, like, I'm a little Lana Del Rey cat winged eyeliner girly. Okay, she's pretty. Okay, y'all. Wings.
On fleek.
Remember when everyone used to say on fleek? Do people still say on fleek? All right, guys, it's time for the new mascara. I hope this mascara doesn't smear because this is the one that I was using before. And once I started my new glowy makeup routine, she was smearing. Literally after like 2 hours, I would like go get boba with a friend and I'd come home and I would look like a raccoon. It was terrifying. I feel bad, you know, like I'm not trying to scare my friends away. So I used to use this before that, and I hope that the waterproof version is resistant to the glow, the wet, glowy dewiness of my new makeup routine. But first, it's time for the mechanical device. Ah, moment of truth, look how clean this applicator is because I've never used it. Oh my God, I'm scared, okay. Please make my lashes luscious. Bruh. That looks like I put nothing on. I feel like, even though this is like almost out, I feel like look, which is better? This is the Lash Paradise and then the Essence on top of it. And this is two Lash Paradises. I don't know. Whatever, whatever girlies. I love this brow pencil. I'll go to the grave with it. I haven't used any other brow product since I was like 15.
What the hell?
Okay, I'm actually gonna wear this Revlon Wine with Everything lipstick. Like, isn't she so pretty? Like, I feel like she's just so perfect mix between red and pink. I feel pretty, guys. And then I'm gonna go with my Juicy Bomb lip gloss. Oh, look at that. Luscious. Please tell me you don't wanna kiss me right now. My lips do look so kissable. Okay, girl. Makeup is chick check time. We're cutting my hair.
What the fuck?
Okay, you probably knew that because you saw the list at the beginning. But yeah, let's get to it. My apartment is so hot, I gotta get air circulation in here. So I open my door, please ignore the mess that is my room behind. Okay, y'all, I'm watching a YouTube tutorial from Tina and Gio, who's watching a tutorial from someone else, so it's kind of like Inception. But like, people in the comments were just like,
oh my god, like you're so much better than like all the other tutorials, da 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 da.
So I'm like, okay, we're gonna trust her. So she put her hair, I'm scared, guys. She put her hair in two ponytails. Oh, by the way, if I didn't mention, we're doing a wolf cut. Oh my god, I'm sorry, this part is so chaotic. I'm literally impulsively cutting my hair pretty much. I'm just done. Like, I need to cut off the dead parts of my life, you know? And like, I feel like that just translates into hair. Okay, next, she put her hair in front of her like this. Oh my gosh, actually, I'm really nervous. I literally am supposed to chop all this off. Let's just do it. Let's just do it.
2 seconds later.
Oh my god, I'm gonna cry. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, just do it. Just do it. Oh my gosh. That looks so funny. You just look a little fishy in the sea. And then she just went in and like, you know, Edward Scissorhands it. Give a little texture so it's not so blunt, you know, it's not like a straight line. I'm gonna tie up this back section. Truth be told, y'all, I feel like this is a crapshoot. Maybe I should have watched like multiple people's videos before full sending this. Okay, I'm just impulsive, so I just want to randomly decide that this is as much as I'm gonna cut off. She cut it like standing up, so that's what I'm gonna do. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I just started cutting. What if I did it wrong? Oh, I don't care. I literally have a bottle at this point if necessary. Oh no. Oh no, it didn't chop, guys. Yo, this is so crusty. Okay, here we go. Almost. Yeah! I feel like I'm going through a crisis, but we're not. We're just glowing up. Oh my god. Oh. Okay, she's not as short as I expected. Here we go. Wait, she actually doesn't look like as shaggy as I expected. So maybe I didn't cut like enough. Let's just cut some more off.
What?
I'm so impulsive. Yeehaw! By the way, a wolf cut would have been like $50 to $80 at a salon without tip. So like this is, I feel like I can do what is necessary. Oh, shit. She's short this time. Wait. Oh, I like it though. Oh my gosh, y'all, I really want to dye my hair blue now. Here she is, like, in the back. How does she look in the back, guys? Like this video if it looks good. If it doesn't look good, also like this video so I can be Delulu and think it looks good. I don't know. I kind of even want to go more crazy with it and just, like, I'm a hairstylist going for real. Okay, I feel like she's really cute. I don't even know if you can tell the difference. I feel like lighter and airier and just good. I feel good. And here is all the hair I took off. Good morning, y'all. It's October 2nd. Hi, so jumping in to say, I know I was gonna do all the physical glow up stuff first, but I ran out of time in the day, so we had to switch tactics. I just cannot stand how messy my space is. Even though I said I was gonna do everything physical transformation first, I feel like we need to break into the mental space and just start cleaning. We're gonna start with the kitchen. I'm gonna show what it looks like. Please don't judge me, and also trigger warning because it's scary looking. Okay, I'm really so nervous, but yeah, this is the state of it. It's not like too bad over here, but I still wanna like wipe all that down. Like, it was just really hard to keep my kitchen clean while I was sick. And also I've just been so sad because of everything going on. So that's the reality of the situation. But it's fine because we're gonna be little cleaning fairies right now and get it looking sparkling. Okay, hair is up. Adventure time is on. Let's get to cleaning.
Adventure time! I did what I was supposed to. There's nothing left for me to do. So now I'm walking out my head through open windows. Cause that's what I feel like. Do it tonight. Waking up my brain, baby.
Y'all, the kitchen is finally clean.
Look at the beauty of this counter.
Oh, the empty sink. The clean stove. I'm so proud of myself. I had to stop from cleaning to have my work day, but the work day is over now.
It's time to attack the bedroom and the bathroom.
The bathroom? Oh, that's gonna be really scary, but for now, let's start with the bedroom. It's not, okay, I was about to say it's not too bad, but I feel like I'm gonna be embarrassing it's not too bad if y'all are like, girl, it's kind of bad. Oh, this is bad. That's, I'm gonna censor my tissues.
At first, I was doing like a good job of keeping my room relatively clean and like keeping the Kleenex
in the trash bag,
but there was just a low moment, okay, where I just gave up. But it's okay because we're gonna make this room look like a freaking beautiful museum or something. I don't know if that's a good analogy, but
I'm gonna start with my door and just make my way around. But first, gotta wash these sheets.
My friend nostalgia, I found you when I heard the sweet sound. Who I once knew so well. In a voice memo from years ago, we were laughing about some nonsense. Oh, how I miss those friends. Circumstances made it so that I'll never see their faces, except for check in once in a while. But best friends are growing.
So this basket has been left untouched for like the last month because it has a bunch of stuff from Gage, but it is time to rid my space with Gage things. So we're gonna go through it, do the hard thing, and get it out.
And I wanna tell the reason why I'll never get to see them, but clearly they don't need to know. Still on my phone, I'll look back at the pictures and I'll reminisce when I'm alone to keep myself from forgetting. Will we ever meet again on this side of heaven?
Jinx's work.
Oh my gosh, y'all, my mom just called me and said she took my car to a second auto shop to get it looked at and they think they fixed it for $150. Oh my gosh, I literally might be saving thousands and thousands of dollars right now if I get this car and it works. So wish me luck. Yay, friends, I'm finally home after picking up my car. The AC is busted in my car. And my tire has a nail. Okay, literally my car is a joke. Like, girl's on her last leg. But at least she ran, and like, as long as I can get from point A to B, I'm happy.
Jinxie, about the sheets. Yay, sheets. Yay, sheets. Yay, sheets. I think I have too many stuffies for my small bed. I think it's due time that I put away the stuffies that Gage gave me, or at least these two. Boba is also from Gage, but y'all know that's like one of my favorite stuffies. So we're just gonna forget. Like, I'm a single mom now, it's fine. But these two, I think I'm gonna take them to my home with my mom, have them out of sight, out of mind, and also just not be drowning in a bed full of stuffies, you know? I forgot that I have this mood lighting that I used in the back of my Q&A video. It's just been sitting collecting dust. I am gonna make it moody and vibey in here.
so vibey, guys. Oh my gosh. My whole room's blue now. I feel like an aquarium.
Okay, here's my room. I don't know if y'all can tell, but it's much cleaner than before. Right, Jinxie?
Jinx is looking around like, girl, this is all yours.
Ooh, this is nice. Girl, this orange is you right here? Okay. They don't smell like roaches in here or nothing.
This is the last space we need to clean. It's actually not too messy. It's just low-key dirty. My cat's litter box is in my restroom, so there's a bunch of litter like on the floor from like her dragging it out of her box. So we definitely need to clean that. And then there's a bunch of like hairs in the sink. I can't show it. The sink is scary, but just trust, she needs a good scrub.
Something about like hair is so gross to clean up. Like, I don't care if it's hair that literally fell out while I was showering. If it's not on my head, it's disgusting. I did not realize how truly dirty my counter was. Soap. That's glued to the countertop. Into the sink pit I go. Oh my god, I want to throw up. I literally want to throw up. Tell me why I just pulled hair out of the drain. Cut the cameras. My heart is beating so fast. That literally was like a horror movie. Thought I was gonna pull like a little girl with long hair out of the drain.
Yay, beautiful. Good is new.
Okay, the last part of cleaning my bathroom is sweeping and vacuuming the litter. It's literally gotten so bad that I am wearing some slippers. Yeah, it's been a long time coming that I sweep. This is humbling, y'all. Since I don't have my scrub daddy, I can't clean my bathtub, so that's still gonna have to be done later. But for now, my restroom is sparkly clean, and I'm so excited that I can actually walk with my bare feet now.
Bruh.
Now for my reward, the ripping! Okay, so we're gonna go to Goodwill to thrift a new outfit. Tomorrow, we'll paint my nails and do my hair and see the finished physical glow up. Okay, we're here at the magical place of goodness. Let's start in bottoms because I found a really cute mini skirt and like really cute vintage jeans here before. So I think that's how I want to base my outfit off of. Wait. Oh my gosh, it's pleated. And there's a blue one. What? Oh my gosh, this is insane that I found both of these guys. I love mini skirts and they're so cute. They are 100% giving cotton candy vibes. Side note, this microwave is so cute. All right, let's find a top. Oh, this is cute. Simple but cute. Oh, girl. $6 for an Old Navy shirt. This is kind of cute. Little academia sweater moment. Now, this is also $5.99, but like, that makes sense, you know? Okay, you know what? Let's head over to lingerie because that's like my favorite section and we could find a gem. I saw this really cute lingerie slip, but it was just a little too hot pink, so I kept looking, and y'all, so, I love the brown, oh my gosh. She is literally giving. I just can't with like how cute these details are. It's not even on yet, and I already feel beautiful.
So I also want to get a cute little hot girl walk outfit because I want to start hot girl walks, but obviously we have to have an outfit for that. So let's find some cute active wear. I'm preferably looking for like the in-between of a sports bra and like a top, like a tank top, because the tank tops are too conservative, but then the sports bras are too like not conservative, the opposite of. So, ooh, something like this in the middle. Okay, wait, I really like, that does not work. It's just because it's stretchy though, like I'm pretty sure it'll trust the process. There are the deodorant stains, but I'm pretty sure we can get those out. And then girls also only $2, so like even if we can't get the stains out, $2. That is definitely glowing up on a budget. Let's keep looking for good measure. Ooh, I like this little pink girly moment. She looks like she's a little long because she has this like extra piece here. $5.99. Girl, be for real. I just can't justify spending more than like $5 on an activewear piece because I just feel like that was sweating on someone's body. Like, I don't want to pay more than $5 for someone's like leftover sweat, greasy items, you know? Okay, let's find some bottoms to go with the top.
I really wanted to find bottoms that were the same color as the top, and so I went to this section.
Ooh, these are so giving American Apparel in like the Tumblr era. They're cute. The little athletic stripe, I love it. Wait a minute. There is no way these shorts are 10 whole dollars.
Wait, but they have the exact same shorts for $5, but they're in size large. That has to be criminal. Wait,
they're literally the same shorts.
Bruh.
That's crazy. Like they're actually $5 more? Something about this feels illegal. I'm wondering if I can make the large fit me. We're gonna get both and try them both on and hope that the large does something for me because $5.
Okay, let's see if we can find any black. I still love black. Oh wait, that kind of caught my eye. These look like cute little shorts. I love that bright pink on the back. Ooh.
The bright pink doesn't really go particularly with this like dark maroon of the top, but like who can deny a little hot pink little detail? Like, let's go.
Here's the athletic top on with the shorts. It looks so cute together. These are the size small shorts. They're a little small, I feel like, so maybe the large actually will work.
But I love them together. I'm definitely feeling hot enough for my hot girl walk.
Oh my god.
Bitch, what the fuck?
Absolutely not. Why does it look like that?
Here's the black shorts. Oh, look at that little pink detail. I actually really like these. Oh my gosh. And these are cheaper. They're $5. So they're cheaper than the $10 American Apparel ones. So I think we should go with these.
Okay, the skirt is cute, yes. But what y'all can't tell is the material. Like, look at that. It looks so cheap, low key. You know what I mean? Like, I literally feel like I'm like wrapping a present with the skirt. With the way it just looks like paper.
But like, can you tell from like far away?
But like, I don't know, like they're still so cute. Ugh, what do y'all think?
Okay, I'm actually not sure. So I'm gonna ask y'all on my Instagram and see what y'all think.
The dress is so cute. We are 100% getting it as my glow up outfit. I can't wait to show y'all.
But for now, no peepsies. Okay, y'all overwhelmingly voted to thrift at least one of the skirts, so I'm gonna get them, and then if I end up not liking them, I'll just post them on my Depop. Okay, I was gonna just paint my nails at home for free, but then today at Share Tea, this girl had the cutest red nails ever. Like this beautiful, dark, witchy, sultry red. And I was like, oh, your nails are so cute. She was like, girl, the press ones from Target $10. And I was like, girl. I'm there.
Okay, so she said it's this brand, Olive and June, and I think this is them. Oh my gosh, here they are, guys. Like, you were not telling me these are the prettiest. They're so witchy, and look how like pretty they are in the light. Wait, y'all. These are cute too. Look, they have little hearts.
Okay, but like, why is Target popping off?
Which ones do I get, y'all? These are more like fall vibes, but these little hearts are adorable.
Or imagine mix and matching them. The ring finger could have like the heart, and the rest could be like the red. Okay, but we're trying to control budget, so let's just do one. Maybe we can do that in the future. As y'all know, I can never make a decision for myself, so I asked my Instagram followers. You guys said the dark red, so we're gonna full send the witchy vibe.
It's time to do my nails. And we're gonna be watching Gilmore Girls while doing them to get us in that fall vibe.
Now, girly, if you've never done press-ons, here's all the tips you need. Remove any nail polish and then file down your nails as well as buffing them. You want to have a rough surface and short nail to start with. Then you've got to push back your cuticles, make space to put them press-ons on. Now, picking out the right nail size is probably the hardest, but you got to dig through all the different options and find the nail that matches yours. It's not too big, like going over your nail, or too small to where it can't flatten out and fit. Once you've used an alcohol pad to wipe down your nails and dry them out, you can start gluing your nails on by putting glue on both your own nail as well as the press-on nail, and then putting it on for 30 seconds, holding it there so it really glues down. And voila!
Oh my gosh, y'all. Look how amazing they look. They literally look like vampire claws. Can you tell I'm obsessed?
It is time to do my hair. Okay, y'all are totally gonna judge me. I am gonna use this without heat protectant.
You need to leave.
Girls, calm down. I know. I forgot to ask my mom to bring my heat protectant, okay? And it's just once. Like, my hair's still really long, guys. Like, I feel like I didn't cut it. The intrusive thoughts are winning. I feel like I'm so bad at this, guys. What if I put one of my bang rollers? Oh my gosh, wait, the way big braid. You guys, I feel like a genius, am I not? Yes. Now this is supposed to curl.
In this moment, my world came crashing down.
I was supposed to curl the bottom layer out. I wanna cry. Okay, no. Girl, we're girl bussing. Don't even worry, girl. We're gonna get this fixed. Oh, look how beautiful that looks. It's fine. We're flipping. Oh, wait, that actually took so nicely. It's like.
Yes, girl, I know I was supposed to flip out, but I didn't say anything. I just let you.
But now I'm gonna serve. See, it's too long.
So I proceeded to try to style it, but girl, it's just not working. Like, it looked so ugly.
We're switching tactics. I'm cutting more hair. I'm really so impulsive with it. It's got some length, babes. I'm gonna do it. I don't even care. I can't even see. Is that even?
Bruh.
I don't know, like that much? Oh my god, why does that look so short? Oh my god, you guys, wait. Oh my god, the impulsiveness has gotten a little too real, guys. Okay, it's fine, because either way, I'm gonna look gorge. Oh, girl, that still looks like I did nothing. Literally, what? Does she look different? Please tell me she looks different. I kinda like her. Maybe she is a little different. She looks a little more shaggy, maybe. Okay, I cut just a little bit, like I trimmed the ends just like with my hair down, and I actually think it looks different now. Like,
does it? I don't know, guys, just
whatever. It feels much healthier now because the dead ends are like definitely all gone.
Oh, so you can like see the layers on the side. I really like that. But we're still a sleigh.
Here's the hair cut if you were curious.
It's outfit time! So I wanted to make this little putting on the outfit segment super aesthetic, like the famous fashion YouTubers who always do little clips like this, but I just like couldn't be serious. But I tried and I felt like it looked elegant anyways.
This is the final glow up look. I literally feel so pretty. I feel like I'm ready to go out in the world and conquer it as the beautiful princess I am. I also love my makeup. I feel so glowy, and my new hair length. Ah, it's definitely shorter. Like it used to be here. So we definitely got some length chopped. But now that we're done with the physical glow up, it's time to finish the mental glow up.
Okay, so the first thing on my mental checklist, well, besides cleaning, which we already did, is to compliment or like start conversations with strangers. Because I feel like talking to strangers can immediately make your day better. And you also never know like who you're gonna meet. It could be the love of your life or your new best friend or someone that just has a cool story and makes you change your perspective on life. And like, I'm trying to level up my life like that. So I'm about to head to a coffee shop to do the last two items on my mental list. But first I wanna stop and get boba. We're gonna find someone in there to compliment and or start a conversation with.
Here we are.
How are you?
Good.
Can I get the classic green milk tea, please? I really like your necklace, by the way. It's really gorgeous. Okay, I don't know if that went well. He kind of looked annoyed. Maybe he was just having a bad day, but it's okay, because I feel like I need some rejection to get over the fear of talking to strangers. Ring secured, but there's two girls ordering right now that look really cool, and I grabbed a picture of them to show y'all. So I'm gonna try to compliment them before I leave.
Excuse me, I just wanna say y'all look so cool. Like, I love your hair and I love your makeup and like, y'all just look really cool. Oh, thank you. Okay, thank you. Bye, y'all.
Okay, y'all, I feel like I'm gonna shit my pants because when I drove past the coffee shop, it was like stocked full of people. Like a little can of sardines. And that probably means there's no tables, which means I will either have to walk around the coffee shop waiting for an empty table for like 30 minutes to an hour. I leave, or I could try to ask if I could share a table with someone. Well, I'm gonna confront any ounce of social anxiety right now. That's probably the scariest thing I've ever asked a stranger in my life.
Hi, excuse me. This is like a really weird question, but there's like no available tables. Uh-huh. Do you think I could sit with you?
Absolutely.
Oh, I can? Yeah. Okay, thank you. Are you sure? Absolutely. We have space for two computers. Okay, thanks anyway. Okay, thank you. Okay, let me grab my bag because I left it over there. Oh, that's so perfect. Thank you. My laptop's really giant. Sorry. Okay,
I used to have a giant.
It's my work computer. I don't know why they gave me the biggest computer. Okay, I'm gonna go grab my bag and bring it back. Thank you.
Now it's time to sign up to volunteer. So I decided I wanted to volunteer as part of my glow up because I think that volunteering not only helps your community, but it helps you to stay connected to your community and to really feel like you have a purpose that's greater than just yourself, but is also helping those around you. And so I kind of knew I wanted to volunteer at the food bank because I volunteered there a little bit in high school and I knew that they were great at making tangible change and really helping communities, families, and people in need. So I went to their website and I looked at the different opportunities they had at different branches, looking at the kind of activities that we'd be doing, the times and days of shifts that they had available, etc. And then once I chose a branch I wanted to volunteer at, I signed up for a volunteer spot. So it actually took me so long to edit this video that I had my volunteer opportunity before posting. So here are two pictures I took while I was at the food bank. It was such a great experience, y'all. They just had us going through food that had been donated and checking for expiration dates and damages and things like that to make sure the items could go to those in need. But like, they were like playing 2010s jams. I made like two friends while I was there. I was like, okay, like this is literally the vibe. Like, I love being able to help people in need, and also it was just like a good jamming experience. Like, it was just such a great way to donate 3 hours of my time to feel like I was making an impact in the community, and I'm so grateful for it. So I definitely will continue to do this. It's something that I definitely want to spend my free time doing. So I forgot to film an outro, but that's the end of the glow up video. Yay! Thank you guys so much for watching. Jinxie and I are very, very grateful. If you made it this far, comment the sparkle emoji for the glow up. I love y'all so, so much. I am so grateful for y'all, and I can't wait to see y'all in the next Thrift With Me video. Bye!